off acknowledging that you are holy, God. Father, that you are worthy, God, that you are worthy of all the worship, Father. Worthy is the Lamb of God that was slain for our sins. Worthy is the Lamb of God, Jesus, he who knew no sin, who became sin for us, that we might be the righteousness of God. Father, I just declare your righteousness over mission right now, that his righteousness is not predicated upon his performance or his good works, but his righteousness is predicated upon his surrender and what the good work of Jesus Christ has already done and laid before him. And therefore, I declare, Father, that you are his shepherd and he shall not want. Father, that you will make mission lie down in green pastures and lead him beside still waters. Father, that you are the restorer of his soul, that you will lead him in paths of righteousness for your name's sake. And although some seasons he may feel or even walk through the valley of the shadow of death, Father, I declare that he will fear no evil, for you are with him.
When I woke up, I was heading towards the kitchen and I overheard my mom and my auntie talking, saying that we wouldn't have no money for Thanksgiving dinner. So I'm like, man, that's tough. So I went and found my cousin. He was outside, him and Joseph. And you know, I told him what happened, and Joseph said, man, it's kind of the same thing for us. We don't have no money to eat. And we kind of just all collectively was like, nah, man, we gotta make something happen. No, we were struggling, bro. It was me, my two cousins, my three cousins, my auntie, and me and my brother, and my mom all in the same apartment. So we just said, man, we're gonna make something happen this year. So man, we grabbed some rakes, we grabbed a lawnmower, some bags, and we went out on a journey, and we went from house to house. We started knocking on everybody's door. Hey, we'll rake your grass, we'll mow your lawn, we'll do all of that just for some extra money. And we just kept getting no's. And we see this guy looking at us. He was like, what's he looking at? You know, so we kind of just, like, just keep walking. But anyway, he gets our attention and, you know, we go over and he asks us what we're doing. We like, man, we just trying to, you know, rake some grass for some extra money, mow a lawn. He was like, all right, y'all can do mine. And we was like, all right, bet. We got to it. We got to it, man. I think that's the best lawn we ever did. So, you know, he ends up saying that he's going to go to the store. We was kind of nervous. Like, man, we hope this dude will come back. We did all this work, so we better come back. So anyway, he ended up coming back, and he gives us $100. And we like, man, we ain't got no change. And he's like, nah, that's all for y'all. And we felt dude was a little weird. It was like, why are you so nice though? You know what I'm saying? So we just said, thank you. So he asked us if we saved. And then it clicked. I was like, oh, okay, that's why he's so nice. He's a Christian. and I kind of knew God. I think I accepted Christ in my life, but I didn't really know what it was. I wasn't really, you know, tripping off of it like that, been to church or whatever. So we all accepted Jesus Christ that day. And that I was just like, man, that's crazy. This dude was this nice to us. He gave us $100. We was just thankful for that. And then, man, he asked us, he said, do you guys have any food for Thanksgiving? We was like, no. And we was just honest with him. He was like, that's actually why we're out here now trying to hustle up some money so we can help feed our family. And, he told us that day, he said, our church is actually giving away turkeys. We're giving away boxes of food. And he said, they'll deliver it right to our steps. And we gave my address and everything. And for sure enough, man, they delivered it. And, you know, we felt proud of ourselves, man. We felt empowered. He was like, man, we really did the right thing. We went out and got it the honest way. Because everything around us is just, you know, could be negative. And we could have chose any path, but that day we chose the right path, and I was proud of us, man. Our parents was proud of us, and I think that's the first day. You know what, matter of fact, I know that's the first day when God showed me that less is more.
Rod was the man of the family. Mom worked two jobs just so we can have sandwiches. Anything good always came with some damages. I had to stick to the code like it's laminate. Ay, wifey was down, had to stay with a reeler. That basement was cold and we ain't have a heater. My actions speak louder than words from a speaker. The street taught me things I couldn't learn from a teacher. I had to hold up 11 years old. I only go off the things that you show. All of my circle been solid as gold. Don was a real one, may God rest his soul. I'ma stay down when I pledge my allegiance. I made a choice to step back for a season. I made a choice to just fight all my demons. It's not that you hate, it's just you not believing. Basically, I'm finna go up, no slacking. Just action, that's facts, and I swear ain't no capping. Honestly, I cannot get too attached. How he's off of the latch, and I throw all the baggage. You judge a book by its cover, I'm covered, I'm covered. I know he gon' finish the story. Really, it's nothing to send him in action. I promise to chill, and that's word to my shorty.
Man, the last album was me trying to find myself. Kenny would just send me any type of beat. Brandon would send me any type of beat, and I kind of just wrote to it. And then there was songs on that last album where I was like, hey, I want to do a song like this. Hey, I want to do a song that can cross over to CCM. Like, I really said that to AG, and he sent me a beat that sounded like CCM. And I think that's the difference between these albums. And this new album, and Less Is More, I'm not trying to do a song that sounds like or do a song that caters to. I'm trying to do what caters to my conviction. And I think I found my sound. And I think in this album, people will hear that. I think it's I've grown maturity and immaturity in my lyrics and not taking a bar off and, you know, just being okay with the sound and the type of music that most moves me, that most motivates me. And my last album was personable. Like, you know, it was real personable. It was dedicated to my grandma. But I felt like in some of the songs, I wasn't as authentic because I was trying to cater to a certain sound to just be honest, to blow up. But then I found that, like, I can do that type of music, but that's not what's true to me. And in this album, it's true to me. And I think it's important that people hear that, because this is the mission that you'll get from here on out. And I can't change that, because I'm so confident and comfortable where I'm at. Not comfortable in where I'm complacent, but comfortable and confident that God is with me in this season of the music that I'm making. And it's raw, it's uncut. I didn't change the message. I just changed the method of how I'm doing it. And I'm excited. And I think it's important, because people can get from this, like, be yourself 100%. And you don't gotta do what you think other people want you to do, or what you think will sound good to other people. It's just, I can give you everything that you
want, is for sure. Ain't no woman like the one I got. You know, if I had them packs on me, she'd spin that block. Okay. If I pass her the blick, she'd take that shot. But it said she prayed for me when the things got hot. Yeah. They was saying they was fours, but they ain't gon' rock. No way. Ain't no falling out of love, cause it's they don't stop. No way. Ain't nothing that you want that I ain't gon' cop. That's fast. Had to put the cuffs on you, but I ain't no cop. Yeah. Cop an attitude when I be bugging you. Yeah, that's okay, cause I'm your bugger. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey. Strong bond, cause what we been through. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Look, two-seater, it's just me and you.
Man, the family, they play a huge role, because, you know, look, I know I'm difficult, especially when I'm trying to create, when I'm trying to get something done. I can be very difficult, and shout out to wifey, Shanae, because she has to endure it all. But that's a huge blessing, though, because I know some people wouldn't be able to deal with it, but she handles it well, man. Like, me being, because when I'm being creative, I get silent, I get moody, and I'm just difficult, to be honest. And man, and the kids, Aaron, Margie, Aubrey, and Lil Tone, you know, they are my first ears, like, because they hear me. I record a lot in my home, so the music is loud. They gotta be quiet, they gotta cut their games off and be silent. And then they're my first ears, because they got, hey, what do y'all think of this? And, you know, they keep it real. Like, nah, dad, that's not it. You know, I get offended sometimes, but whatever. They're my first ears, man. So you know, but they also tell me when it's good, and I know they be honest with me. So they play a huge role, and weirdly, I can't do this without them. When I think about less is more, man, I think about this Jay-Z line. He was like, I told him less is more, homies, plenty of us. Cat rules everything. Anyway, that's what I think of, man, loosely. But on a deeper level, it's that story, you know, about having nothing or what you think is nothing, and just watching God, you know, multiply it. And I think that's my life, man. Having to, even starting out music, having kind of bare minimum and having to make something out of nothing with little, and watching God just bless it. And just, and music and my marriage, having, you know, losing it all, and look at where we are now. And it's really amazing how God continues to take my little and make it more. And that's what I want people to get. That's what I want people to see in their life. I think when you listen to the album, you'll hear it. But then when you listen to a second, a third, and a fourth, you'll really understand it. Because there are sprinkles of just nuggets here and there. And I want people to leave encouraged that you may not have what you want, but if you give that little to God, you know, he can make it what you need. And that's my story, man. And that's why I say, like, I can't make it up. I can't, you know, say what it's not. I'm just saying what it is, what God gave me, man. Little dude from Greenville, Mississippi, and, you know, small town, and now I'm in big California, traveling across the world. And right now it's on a, you know, it's not on the smallest scale, but it's not on the biggest scale. But I think I'm right where God wants me, and people will be able to see how this little can turn into more, and God will get the glory ultimately from it. So, less is more.
Now you can kill all the rumors. Back in the West, and I move like a shooter. I got a ball like I'm hanging with Cooper. I gotta work, so I make no excuses. I need a worm, so I'm up with the roosters. Ain't got a lot, so I'm making it useful. Beat down the door, and ain't got no approval. Taking the game in spite of refusal. Here they go making them statements. Man, it just sound outrageous. But it's all good, like Megan. Ay, fist in the air, I made it. Yeah. Look, I'm up. No luck. No luck. It's us. No trust. What's yeah. Up? Forget what you heard, man. This life is okay. Amazing. Gain the whole world, but your life can't save it. It ain't no secret I'm bad. 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 I'm about to run up the scope. I'm about to run up the stats. Quit playing, I'm not in your league. I'm about to run up a lap. It ain't no secret I'm bad. It ain't no secret I'm bad. I had to sit up and pray in the morning. Please do not hit me unless it's important. I'm interested in making a fortune. You got a spot on the team if you're fortunate.